Hey guys, it's me, Chris from Raymundo, and today we're back with another reaction video. Today I'm gonna be reacting to Demi Lovato's newest album, Dancing with the Devil, The Art of Starting Over. So, I'm super excited. This is the first Demi Lovato project that I'm gonna be listening to in full. So let me know if you want me to react to other full Demi Lovato albums. But, I saw the YouTube documentary, and I really liked it. It's so insane what she's gone through, and you know, like, genuinely believe that God was with her the whole time. The shit that she's gone through, the shit that she still has to persevere through, oh, it's just incredible, and like my heart goes out to her, and hopefully that she'll be able to heal. I hope she'll heal everything soon. She's in her Saturn return, so I pray that that's gonna help her finally get rid of that challenge off of her. But without further ado, I'm super excited to wrap this album. Let's get into this. Chat number one, Anyone, a song I've heard and a song I've fucking love. I haven't heard a song in a long time, actually. Since like last year, probably. 100 million songs I feel stupid when I sing. Please send me anyone. I need someone. No. Anyone? I realized that I didn't react to it because I watched it on the Grammys video of like two years ago. What? Last year's Grammy, I should say. Not 2 years ago. What am I saying? Anyway, let's move on. Let's move on to track number two, Dancing with the Devil. Ooh. Wow. Okay. Ooh. Ooh, I love that. Okay. See, watching the documentary and then listening to the song definitely helps the experience. Hey!
Dancing with the devil, out of control.
I find it really interesting that it's like, she said, I'm dancing with the devil, I almost end up in heaven. Like, that contrast is so interesting, right? I don't know. That's interesting to me. I don't know. Ooh! Okay, transition? Ooh! Okay.
Dancing with the devil.
It's Demi Lovato. Like, did I expect anything else?
Yeah, I really.
Whoa! I like that. I'm saving that. You know, it's crazy hearing this song and then like, and just like, how was she able to put herself back into that dark place? Like, that is so strong and so powerful and so brave. Because literally, she just said, what the fuck happened to her? Basically, this is the summary of what happened to her the night that she overdosed. So, that's fucking insane, and like, oh my god, like, that's... I don't know what to say, like, really. So, I'm going to be actually reacting to the music video for Dancing with the Devil. So, let's get into this reaction as well. Oh wow, she did the tube with her blood going in there. Not like I wanna do this every night. Think I earned it, feels like it's worth it in my mind. Wow. Hopeless insanity. Okay, the acting, because you could tell she's drunk now.
Dancing with the devil.
Oh, what a white line. I thought, oh wow.
Sanity. I told you I was
I have nothing to say. Honestly, I can't. There's nothing you can say. I feel like. Oh, this bridge. Oh my god, okay. Oh, that's powerful. I'm gonna leave the photo up there so if y'all, you know, need help. Asking for help is not... it's not a pussy thing to do. It's the best thing you can ever do. It's the most heroic thing you can ever do. What can you say to that? Like, what? I have no words. Like, I have nothing to say except just, like... yeah, nothing. Nothing. I don't know what to say. I don't know how to feel. Child number 3, I see you. Madison's lullaby. I didn't want those innocent eyes to watch me fall from this day. Ooh, okay. I wanna be the one you look up to when you wanna. Oh, wow, okay. Oh my god, I can't. My lyric is crazy. If you don't know, she basically got blind right after she got out of her coma. Wow, okay. Wow. Speechless. I really did not have anything to say with that song, too. My assumption is that this song was being sung to her while she was in the ICU. So... wow, this is so powerful already. Like, we're only 3 songs into this album. It's like we're getting a story, her recovery, if that makes sense. So, wow. I don't know what to say. Like, I really don't know what to say or what to think right now because that's so powerful. Lying about her not being able to see. If you haven't seen the documentary, I'll just give you a little like kind of spoiler alert. So you better skip it and be like maybe a minute ahead or something. But basically, Demi said that after her overdose, when she woke up, she actually couldn't see. She was blind. She luckily recovered her vision, but she still has blind spots because of the overdose. Talking about this lyric, I didn't know what she was talking about with this lyric, but she basically said, like, it's poetic that she literally sang that to her, but in the end, she actually couldn't see. So, interesting. Track number 4, intro. Really interesting, but I think I get it. Why the intro is 4 tracks in. It's like anyone happened before the overdose. That's what she said. She wrote anyone before the overdose. Then 2, the night like of the overdose, and 3, the ICU. So I think 4 is the beginning of her recovery. If Dancing with the Devil was not on this album, this would be called The Artist Starting Over. Okay, I understand it now. So track number 4 intro.
I was blind, and now I see. Let me take you on a journey.
Oh, I love that. This is giving me chills.
That sheds the skin of my power of starting over.
Like I just said, told you, we're at the starting over now. Track number 5, The Art of Starting Over. What the fuck? Hey! Ooh, what? Hey! Ooh! Hey! Hell yeah to that. Cheers to that. Exactly! Starting over. Hey, I got the darkness. I got the darkness. Oh, 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 oh. What the fuck? I'm sorry, what happened? What? I was not ready for that, and like that's probably, what? I really like that song because it's very relatable to any situation in reality. We know this is her story and this is what it's for, her overdose, but at the same time, it's very vague. So someone who doesn't know what happened to her can show this in their own way. And I really like that. Try number six, Lonely People. What is this? Upbeat. I was not ready for this. Upbeat sound. Oh, felt that. Okay. Ooh. Damn. Ooh, that guitar. I can't. Ooh. I think that means like the fantasy is dead. That facade is dead. As we are lonely people. 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 Oh my god, that's a bye. This song hurts me. Yep, that last part. You better love yourself, y'all. You are not going to be able to fulfill your needs by someone else. No one is going to fulfill your needs. Trust me. Not going to work. It's going to attract some fucking horrible people into your life. Wounded people, broken people. So, heal yourself, because once you heal yourself and love yourself, and feel in yourself and are in a more happier, healthy, fixed. You can never be really fixed. We're all broken people, but you know, happier light set, light will attract light. Let's move on. I really like that song a lot. I relate to it. Sorry, I can't get over like how different. Like I felt like the vibe changed. And that's so weird. Like this feels like a different album, which it kind of is. Like these, like I feel like the first three songs would be on like an EP called Dancing with the Devil, and like this one is now, you know, the actual album. So try number seven, The Way You Don't Look At Me. But damn. Oh wow. Wow, her time in heaven. Wow. Wow. This album is probably just gonna be me just, you know, sitting here, because honestly, like, what can you say? So she's basically saying here, actions and words really do affect a person. Support, if I don't have support, it feels much worse than the shit that she's overcome. And think about that. Think about that. She survived 3 strokes and a heart attack while she was unconscious. Just like, just support people, please. So you never really know what's going on. And I feel like the best thing is just say something and say words and just say something. Don't just try to shut it out or just pretend that it's not there, because words really do a great impact. For the worse or for the better. This goes with any situation, like with bullying, with depression, with anything, just anything. Support is just everything for someone. Try number 8, Melon Cake. Ooh, that rhymes. The cat and mouse, wow, okay. Oh my god, wow. Okay. Wow. 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 Yeah, probably. That lyric, that's so crazy.
Having cakes on my birthday.
This does sound like a Julia Michaels song. I just kind of looked at it and it is written by Julia Michaels, so.
Ha ha, no more melon cake. Ha ha.
Oh no, we're not doing this. That's powerful.
La 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 la.
Okay, I want to say that's my least favorite song right now, I think. That one, even though the message is powerful, I think this whole album is just going to be powerful. I feel that's my least favorite, just sonically, I don't know. So the thing about Julia Michaels' sound sometimes is really hit or miss for me. It's, I don't know what it is. It's either really hit or miss for me. I mean, fucking Selena Gomez is fine. I'm like, no, we're not doing that. Only with other people. With her, if she sings her own songs, then it's a bop. But with other people, when she writes other people's songs, either hit or miss. You know, Twitter was a song said, you know, she literally has been controlled by her managing team, by everyone around her for years. The only thing she was starving for was attention. When people were thinking that she was just starving herself from food, she just was starving from attention. They were starving her from actual attention. They were just trying to keep her to keep doing the things so they could keep getting money. That makes sense. That's fucking insane. If you don't, it's just, wow. Taking back her power now. Like she said, she's taking back her power. Trend number 9, Met Him Last Night featuring Ariana Grande. This, if they don't do some fucking vocals on this album, I'll be very upset. Because Demi Lovato and Ariana Grande are one of the two most powerful vocalists of this time period. Hands down. We know that. So, let's see what they're going to do to this one. It's explicit too. So, let's see. Ooh, I love the melody already. What? That harmony. Did y'all hear that? Damn. Bye. Okay. Ariana said no. I'm in this whole song. Ooh. That lyric, like literally, ouch.
Now I'm spending the night.
Hey! Why is the perfect mix of trap and pop? They met in the middle.
Hey!
Oh, do you hear her in the back? What the fuck just happened to me? What the hell? That's my favorite song right now. That's my favorite song right now. What? First of all, I'm kind of mad I didn't do Whistle Note, but at the same time, I don't care because what the fuck just happened? It was like a fucking blur what just happened to me. I don't know what I went through, but I went through it. I love how Ariana was a part of the song right from the beginning. She did not like come in like on the second verse and then join in halfway through. No, she was there present the entire song. So was Demi too.
I don't believe in you. I don't believe it.
Oh my god. Oh wow. Okay, that's fucking okay. That's a fair song right now. Hands down, they killed it with that one. They killed it. Pet number 10, What People Say, Demi Lovato and Sam Fisher. Wow. Oh, wow. Wow. Fuck. Ooh, that was like a Lana chord right there. Okay. Oh, his harmony.
What all the people say.
Whoa, his voice! Are you kidding me? Wow. So far, I really like the features. That's very weird that I like the features a lot. This one, okay, the second chorus, I don't know, something about it was different, but when they kind of went back and harmonized and went kind of to sing together, that hit different. I don't know what happened, like the whole thing changed for me. Because, you know, here's the thing, y'all. Y'all need to heal shit first. Y'all just can't say, I'm never gonna be like my parents. No. Because deep down, when you are trapped by that environment, you start to become that environment whether you like it or not. And it's until you start to realize who you are, what happened, or like what's inside of you, you need to heal that and grow from that, and then you won't be like that anymore. You need to heal first. And that's, I think, the most important step people are forgetting. The healing process. And healing never ends, but if you heal, this love and happiness of the light will come and follow you throughout your healing journey. So there's no destination, it's just, it's gonna come as you're going along with it. Chat number 11, Carefully.
Oh, it sounds like a Selena Gomez song. What song is this? Bad Liar, Bad Liar. It sounds like Bad Liar.
So this is probably written by Julia. Right? No, wow, I'm surprised it's not. Okay. Oh, wow, it's gonna hit different. This is gonna be my song right here.
And I think we need way too damn needing.
Hey! 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 Ooh! Hey! Wow, okay, awesome. They're rocking problems, people. And that's strength. So show your true self.
You can know me carefully. Please handle me carefully.
Wow, it's crazy. And it's interesting because it goes into the kind of lover I am, track number 12. That's crazy that it goes into that, because, you know, she basically said at the end, like, if you handle me carefully and love me like this, then you don't know what you just opened up. You don't know what you just opened up in my heart. I love that song, though. I really relate to that song. Sadly, I do. I'm very, very high maintenance. So that's why I'm not in a relationship, because I'm working through it. Chat number 12, The Kind of Lover I Am. I'm here for this guitar sound. This sounds like another song on this track, or on this album. This sounds like the first track, The Art of Starting Over.
The kind of lover I am.
Ooh! Yep, I'm the same way too. Wait till afterwards.
The lover I am.
Hey! Ooh, this is such a vibe. This album's a vibe. That's what it is. A sad contemplated vibe. That's what I would describe this album as. Yeah, not gonna end. We're not gonna end as passion yet, no.
Love I am. That's the kind of lover I am. Another one night stand. That's the kind of lover I am. Hey!
Exactly! Period. She's open, y'all. She's open to anyone. God, this album is just such a fucking mood. That's what this album is. I like that song a lot. You know, what's a relationship? You know what? I'm here, and I'm alone. And although it sucks to see people having, like, you know, love relationships, you know, I'm happy. And I'm happy that I get to be my own person and really independent and free, because that's, you know who I am, I guess. Maybe there's a lot of, there's maybe a little bit of issues and some stuff going on down there, but you know what? Track number 13, Easy, which is Demi Lovato and Noah Cyrus. Do we even have to, like, I'm so ready for this. Noah, you did it with that album last year, so I'm ready to see what you're gonna do with Demi. Let's do this. I'll leave through the gift shop. I'm keeping all my souvenirs. Wow, okay. Hey! Ooh. Oh, Noah. I'm done. I don't know what to say. Y'all here for a reaction? I ain't giving you one because I don't know what to do. I'm keeping all my souvenirs. So I'm thinking that's her leaving the hospital, which is fucking crazy, I think. In an interview, they showed her like a clip of her coming out of the hospital and there's like just a bunch of paparazzi. And she had to make it look easy. Like, I'm just, that's like just, I think, another burden of fame. One of your highest moments, there are people going to just want to be so invasive. And that's kind of sad. I like this song, though. Noah did a really good job. I love Noah on this song. Track number 14, 15 minutes. Oof, tell me about it. Tell me about that. Exactly. Yeah, me too. Yeah, me too. This is literally me. Hey!
We were looking for 15 minutes.
Okay, I have two things. The song could be about two things, I think. Ooh, I love that. That's 15 minutes. I liked it. Not my favorite, but I think something definitely will listen to again. I love the second verse where she's like, I know I'm ahead, but I'm working on it. So it's an honor that, like, you know, I let you into my life because I don't let anyone into my life. You should take it as a compliment, but you fucking ruined it. So you didn't want goodbye. Like, leave. You're not worth my time. Felt that. I really felt that in my soul and in my gut because that's literally me. That's literally me. Track number 15, My Girlfriends Are My Boyfriend, featuring Swae. Yeah. My angels. Hey! Okay. Ooh. Hey. Hey. Honestly, agree. It's more lit. My girlfriend is my boyfriend. My body knows way better to forever do his part. Hey. Ooh. Hey. Cause all my boyfriends, but they won't mess up my makeup. I mean, sometimes friends break up. Sadly. I know it all too well. Okay. I really like that song because it's true. You know what? I'd rather have friends than a relationship right now. I'm not looking for anyone. In fact, like, why? Like, why would I want to put myself out there and get hurt? No, like, that's not gonna happen. Mm-mm. I'd rather just be my friends, be happy, and, you know, be free and independent to do my own thing without having someone. That's just my thing right now, I guess. I'm probably really different than other people around me. I mean, considering I haven't been in a relationship for all the 17 years of my life. Yeah. Okay, let's move on. Chat number 16, California Sober. She said in the documentary that California Sober, particularly where she's like, moderately drinks wine and smokes weed. That's the only thing she does. She does it, like, on moderation. So, let's see what this song is about. Hey. Exactly. You're still growing. You're still gonna learn, but. So loud. It really isn't. So hey! Ooh, I love that. Girl, my party's over. No. Why is so bad? If you hear music, I'm really sorry. I'm done here. I want to move out. Anyway, I really like that song. See, even though she's still drinking and she's still drinking in moderation, does not mean that she's still growing and one day she won't be fully sober. But just right now, the road to recovery this way is working for her. She's able to moderate her intake of, you know, the things that, you know, she was overdosing on and, you know, getting addicted to. Now she's moderating it because that's the way she's going to get through it. She needs to have it still, but she doesn't want to depend on it anymore. Because I think cold turkey does not work for her. You know, sometimes cold turkey can actually be the worst thing for you. It's going to literally, it could kill people. Happy that she's found her method that's going to help her in the long run. Try number 17, Mad World. Oh, fuck off. Okay, this is a cover? Okay, cool. Interesting, I like that though. That definitely fit, this definitely fits with the theme. Like, this definitely has a place, for sure. Ooh, nice cover. Definitely, I would see myself listening to the cover, too. I like her take on it. Very epic, very smooth though. It's not like overwhelming. Track number 18, Butterfly. Damn. I feel like I need that build up. Hey, true. Wow, I felt this. I love this pre-chorus. Hey, let's go. She didn't fail us. Ooh. Ba-ba-da-da-da. I liked it. I actually like this one. It's very chill and something I really relate to, I feel like. Especially like forgiveness is the hardest truth. You have to choose to do it. You know, all those things. Like, I had a part of me that I hide, but now I need to let it out. I'm growing from it to be no more looking for signs. That's what I'm going through right now. Sometimes you just need to let God or whatever you believe in take control. So sometimes things that are not meant for you are gonna fall apart and it's gonna hurt because you're so attached to them, but in the end they were not meant for you, or they were not meant for you, or you just outgrew it and you're ready for something new. Try number 19, Good Place. I've been called an emotional disaster by myself and by so many others after. This is Julia. I heard Julia. Yikes. Money over trust. Ooh, wait. Fuck. I like the song. I like the song. Fuck, I relate to the song. Besides the drugs part, everything else hits. Whole lot of work. Whole lot of hurt, whole lot of grace. I'm a good place. Wow, okay. What I was just saying, what I just tell y'all. Ooh. Well, that ends the main album. I really like that song as an ending. I really feel that. Where I feel like right now, I'm actually in a good place, even though I still have a lot of shit to go through. I feel like I relate to the song because I am in a really good place in my life right now, and I'm thankful for that. But this song is just saying that, hey, I've gone through a lot of hurt, I've gone through with a lot of grace, I've been through some shit, but they fixed me in the end. They helped me fix my situation, fix the foundation that was broken. Because like I said, a tower moment, or a moment where everything feels like it's falling apart, happens because the foundation was not strong. It needs to fall apart so you could rebuild it. And if we stay aligned and we keep being aligned, then I don't think there's necessarily shakeups the universe needs to give us, maybe lessons that we need to learn, but they won't feel like complete hellholes. It's whatever God wants to give us, and whatever, you know, whatever your belief system is. I don't want to assume that you believe in God, of course. I really like that song. So now let's move on to the last track I'm listening to. This is off the expanded version, but I haven't listened to this yet. It's a song of Demi Lovato and Marshmello for Okay Not To Be Okay, yeah. So I haven't heard that yet, and I watched the music video as well, so let's get into this. Ooh, what the fuck? I like this already. Hey, well, let's go. Hey! Ooh, I love this as an ending. Bye. To play, don't give up in the moment. It's okay not to be okay. When you focus and you feel too exhausted to play, not to be okay. It's okay not to be okay. I like that song a lot. I really like that song. Fuck. Because it's true. It's okay not to be okay, just don't get too lost in the moment, but be present in the moment, if that makes sense. Don't just worry about what's happening now, worry about healing yourself and being happy in yourself, and then everything will work out in the end. Even though we have hopes for what happens in the future, I do for sure, trust me, I'm stubborn in the way I think about my future. I know that in the end, I'm going to feel happy. So, let's watch this video now. Feel like a drop in the ocean, that don't nobody notice. Ah, yes, the Game Boy. Yes. Somebody to say, it's okay not to be okay. Hey, it's okay not to be okay. Oh, wow. Is that like a reference to, I think it is. Sunny and the Chance? Oh, that's interesting, because you know, while she was doing that show, shit was going downhill.
It's okay not to be okay. It's okay not to be okay. cost it to pay. To pay not to be okay.
It's kind of beautiful and poetic that Demi is with her now and with her, like, back then, if that makes sense. I like that.
That was Demi Lovato's album, Dancing with the Devil, The Art of Starting Over. I love this album. It's so powerful, so beautiful. Let me say that really quick. Incredible storyline, incredible storytelling, incredible way of describing what happened to her and how she was healing, how she was going through her actual overdose situation. Then, like, actually building on top of her healing journey. Because, yes, the overdose was very horrible or whatever, but the healing process is most important. If you make it out of that alive, which she did, astonishingly, like, it's crazy what she went through during that time. Miracle, really. I do want to say that, you know, whatever you're going through, it's going to be okay. I know from personal experience that, trust me, it gets better. Just because you feel like your life is non-existent or it's falling apart or it's shit is hitting the fan or you feel lonely or sad or whatever, just know that's going to not last forever. That's happening to make you a stronger person. It's going to keep you stronger. It's going to make you a stronger person. It's going to teach you a lesson or teach you lessons that are actually going to benefit you. And are gonna help you with the people that you're going to run into next in your life, for sure. I hope you guys enjoyed this video, and I really enjoyed this album a lot. I need time to see if there's a lot you need to process this album, but very pop. It was very unexpected, honestly. I really did not expect how she was gonna do this, but it was really unexpected. But I really enjoyed it in the end, and I really had a fun time listening to this album. So thank you guys so much for watching, and I'll see you guys in the next video, and let me know if you want to see more Demi Lovato reactions. Bye.